The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and I'm having a tough time today. It's Power Pivot, not that thing that you do presentations in. I have Zeke over here, and Zeke gets a dollar every time I say the wrong word, and he's going to throw stuff at me. So it's Power Pivot. All right, hey, I've got an amazing trick for you today. Now, Power Pivot, we've talked about before. Power Pivot is that product that can take millions of rows of data and mash it up with other data and create pivot tables. I was working on a book last week, and I realized that Power Pivot can do something amazing that's not really what it's advertised for. Check this out. We're going to go to Insert, Pivot Table, click OK. Now I'm going to create a pivot table here where I have year and measure across the top, maybe regions down the side, and then amount. All right, now, problem. 2009 actuals, those are real. 2009 budget, I don't care anymore. And in 2010, I don't want the actuals, I just want the budget, because it's not a full year for 2010. But there's no way to do this in a regular pivot table. There's no way to, if you turn off budget for 2009, it's going to turn off for 2010 as well. All right, so I kind of have some good news, bad news, good news kind of thing. In Excel 2010 or 2010, they added something called name sets that allows you to do that asymmetrical reporting. But it doesn't work for regular Excel data sets. It only works for OLAP data sets, which for those of us who have our data in Excel, we don't have a big IT department behind us, does us no good. All right, check this out. I'm going to press Control T to create a table. I'll come up here and name this table. I'll call it Financials. And now watch this little dance. I'm going to go to Power Pivot, create linked table. Allow it to import that data, and I'm not going to mash any data up. I'm not going to do any calculations here. All I'm going to do is pivot table, single pivot table, new worksheet. Okay, so see that? I took regular Excel data, made it into a table, had Power Pivot import it, and now, all right, let's build that same report again. So we have year in column labels, measure in column labels, region down the side, and amount in the heart of the pivot table, right? Same problem we had before. Ah, but every Power Pivot pivot table is not a regular pivot table, it's an OLAP pivot table. So I can come here to Options, Field Sets, create a set based on column items. All right, so 2009 actual, yes, I want that. 2009 budget, no, get rid of it. 2009 all, don't need it, that's the total. 2010 actual, nope, not yet. 2010 budget, yep, want to keep that, don't need this one. And don't need this one. We'll call it, instead of set one, maybe Bud V Act. Click OK. All right, and check this out over here. We now have an extra virtual field called Bud V Act. It actually replaced year and measure with Bud V Act and 2009 actual, 2010 budget, asymmetric reporting. A huge underutilization of Power Pivot, because you know we're not mashing up millions of rows of data, but a great way to get access to name sets, even though Microsoft is not giving us access to name sets for regular Excel data. Hey, there you have it. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.